Welcome to Mad English TV. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about traveling on a train. Okay, so take a look at these. What are these things called? Well, they're called train cars. Train cars, okay? Now, you need to be careful that you get on the right car, right? Now, the car number will probably be on your ticket. Okay, so you need to look at your ticket and get on the right train car. Now, there's two kinds of trains. Trains that carry people are called passenger trains, and trains that carry goods are called freight trains. Okay, now with passenger trains, a car is often called a coach or a carriage. Okay, so take a look at this ticket. Here it says coach B. Okay, so on the side of the train car, it's going to say B. So you need to look for the car that says B, and then you get onto the car, and then you need to find your seat number. Okay, seat 39A. Okay, now there's window seats and aisle seats. Okay, if you want to sit beside a window, then you need a window seat. And if you want to sit beside an aisle, then you need an aisle seat. So the thing in the middle where you walk is called the aisle. Okay, so you need an aisle seat. Sometimes it's better to have an aisle seat because then you can get up and go to the bathroom or do whatever you want. If you're sitting in the window seat, you need to bother the person sitting next to you, right? You need to say, excuse me, I need to get up and use the bathroom, okay? So I think sometimes I prefer the aisle seat. Okay, up there we have the luggage rack. Okay, so you take your luggage and you put it up onto the luggage rack. Okay, now if you're taking an overnight train, then you probably won't have a seat. You're going to have a berth. A berth, okay? These beds are called berths, okay? So you'd probably be in a sleeper car. A train might have several different cars, a sleeper car, a sitter car, a dining car, okay? Now the first car in the train is the train engine, the engine. Okay, the engine pulls the train. Now the last car in the train is the caboose. Caboose. Okay, now a train might also have a dining car. That's where you go to eat and drink. Okay, so here we have our train. First one is the engine, and then we have the sleeper car, a dining car, and a sitter car. And then at the very end, we have the caboose. Okay, now the person who drives the train is called the engineer, the train engineer. And the person who checks your ticket is called the conductor. Conductor. Okay, here we have tracks. So a train runs on tracks. They're called train tracks. Okay, and the place you go to get onto the train is called the train station. And this is really important, the platform. Okay, this thing here is called the platform. So you need to wait on the right platform. Otherwise, you might get on the wrong train or you might miss your train. Okay, see up there? It says F13. That's the platform number. So on your ticket, it'll probably say the platform number. So you need to make sure you wait on the right platform. Okay, so you need to buy a ticket, right? Before you travel by train, you need to buy a ticket. So you could go to the ticket office, usually inside the train station, or you could buy your ticket from one of these ticket machines. Now, these are sometimes called kiosks. Kiosks. Okay, now you might travel first class, or you might save your money and travel second class. Okay, now the place you're trying to go, the place you want to go, is called the destination. Destination. Okay, now you might be able to take a direct train to your destination, but you might have to make a connection. A connection. Okay, this word is very important. Connection, connect, connecting. Okay, that means you have to change trains somewhere. Okay, let's say we're going from Frankfurt to Munich. Okay, there might be a direct train, but we might have to connect in Stuttgart. Okay, so on your ticket, it might say connect in Stuttgart. So you have to get off your train and then change platforms and then find the train going from Stuttgart to Munich. Okay, now here we have a timetable. Okay, a timetable will tell you if your train is delayed, which means late, or if it's on time. Hopefully, it's on time. Okay, so you get on the train and you get off the train. Now, there's another word for get off, and that is alight. Alight. Now, before I went to Europe, I had never heard this word before. Okay, in Canada or the US, I've never heard this word before. But when I went to Europe, suddenly I heard this word all the time on the subways, on the trains, on the announcements. Ding! Please alight the train. Alight? What does that mean? Okay, but I figured out that alight means to get off. All right, so I've really never heard this word in real English, but when you take a train, you're going to hear this word a lot. I heard it in China, I heard it in Europe, so you're probably gonna hear it too when you travel by train. Okay, I want you to tell me, where do you wanna travel? Let me know down there in the comments. I might be able to give you some tips because I've traveled to I've traveled to more than 25 countries, but I've taken train. I've traveled by train in at least more than 12 countries. Okay, so I think I might be able to give you some advice if you let me know where you want to go. Okay, I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.